So hello friends, I know today we have got the NEET MDS exam date, and life में जब भी कोई डेट आती है ना, we always have that mixed kind of feeling. So as of now, the date is announced, that is 18th of March. So trust me, this is the do or die situation. Do or die situation. So ये 2 महीने तुमसे कोई छीन नहीं सकता, ठीक है? This 2 month Nobody can take away from you, and trust me, this 2 months is actually sufficient. This is actually sufficient for you to give the exam. And trust me, I'm saying this very frankly. 2 महीने, 4 महीने, 6 महीने, it will not make any change in your preparation. So this is absolutely a do or die situation for the students who have followed the Bhatia schedule. शिद्दत से उन्होंने पढ़ाई करी है. कुछ नहीं, अभी 2 महीने में जस्ट डू द क्रैश कोर्स एंड TND और अपना स्केड्यूल खुद बनाना है, ठीक है? एवरीवन हैव टू मेक देयर ओन स्केड्यूल. आज आराम से रात में बैठ के सी विच इज योर वीकर सब्जेक्ट, सी विच इज योर वीकर सब्जेक्ट एंड डू अकॉर्डिंगली. दिस 10 डेज, दैट इज फ्रॉम 20 ऑफ जैन टू फेब, 1st ऑफ फेब. This is a golden period for your preparation. Why I am saying this? Because जो भी backlogs हैं, if you have missed any subject or किसी subject में, I know for interns it is very difficult. कोई subject on and off हो जाता है. Finish all those backlogs in 10 days. जैसे कि बोलते हैं ना trauma में, 1 hour is the golden period for the trauma. So this 10 days is golden period for you guys. Okay? So finish this exam. Don't crib about it कि medical वाला तो जुलाई में हो गया postpone, हमारा मार्च में क्यों है. कुछ नहीं, nothing is important. Finish this paper. Counseling जब भी होगा, हम paper finish करके we will chill and enjoy. Okay? We will have a happy life. So with this positive energy and enthusiasm, we will finish this exam. We will clear this exam. Okay, so let's start with the past year question marathon for the oral pathology. Okay, so everybody be motivated. Aaj ka din, just leave it, just give your this day absolutely for your schedule. Okay, if you are not able to make your schedule, obviously Himani ma'am will take the session on this, how to go about it, how to plan your schedule for this 2 month. But finish this paper. Okay, so past year question, we will see all those important questions which has been asked previously. Now you will tell me all those answers, because these questions have been already discussed, and these questions they have been continuously asking in your INI paper and NEET paper. Okay, now multinucleated giant cells are seen in which of these pathologies? ठीक है, सबसे पहले तो हमें ये देखना है multinucleated giant cells के बारे में options क्या दिए हैं. So basically they have given all the cysts. So कौन से cysts होते हैं जो जिसमें multinucleated giant cells होते हैं? तो basically these are the pseudocyst. मानसी, नॉट सी कैल्सिफाइंग ओडोंटोजेनिक सिस्ट में तो हमें घोस्ट सेल्स दिखते हैं, राइट? सो जनरली मल्टी न्यूक्लिएटेड जाइंट सेल्स, दीज आर सीन इन स्यूडोसिस्ट. ओके, सो व्हाट ऑप्शंस वी हैव स्यूडोसिस्ट? ओडोंटोजेनिक केराटोसिस, इट इज अ डेवलपमेंटल ओडोंटोजेनिक सिस्ट. ओके, कैल्सिफाइंग ओडोंटोजेनिक सिस्ट, अगेन इट इज अ डेवलपमेंटल ओडोंटोजेनिक सिस्ट. सो वी आर लेफ्ट ओवर विथ two options, aneurysmal bone cyst and traumatic bone cyst. Traumatic bone cyst mein we just get dry tap, there is nothing, we just get the dry tap. So option here is aneurysmal bone cyst. So even if you don't know the aneurysmal bone cyst, you will be still able to mark this question. Now see, what do we see in aneurysmal bone cyst? These are blood filled cystic cavity. So can you see this large cystic cavity? These are also called as blood soaked sponge appearance. Now this is the histopath. Can you see this large big cavity is filled with hemosiderin? It is filled with hemosiderin. Now see this image, can you appreciate multinucleated giant cell? See, this is multinucleated giant cell. Now, in aneurysmal bones, this multinucleated giant cell, it is present in close relation with the cystic cavity. Now, presence of this cystic cavity, radiographically, it will give soap bubble appearance. And also, what do we see? Ballooning or the eccentric expansion of the jawbone. Eccentric expansion of jawbone. Okay, so I know you guys are slightly, it is difficult for you to mark the answers of the pseudocyst. So we will discuss all the pseudocysts which have been asked in your previous paper. So histopathologically, as discussed, now I have put exactly the same image which was taught in the class, so it will be easier for you to recall. Now, numerous blood-filled cavernous or the cystic spaces are present. Now, remember, pseudocyst, it is not lined by epithelial lining. That is why it is called as pseudocyst. These spaces are not lined by endothelial cell. That is why these are pseudocysts. Now, what is pseudocyst? It is traumatic cyst, staphylococcus cyst, mucosal, extravasation type, and aneurysmal bone cyst. Remember, there are two types of mucosal. Okay, so extravasation type, it is a pseudocyst. Now, histopathologically, now if there is a confusion between the aneurysmal bone cyst and central giant cell granuloma, because these two lesions are very much similar. Now, what do we see in central giant cell granuloma? There will be no cavernous spaces. It will not be seen in central giant cell granuloma. We will discuss again in the next question. Now, see, identify the histopathological image. So, sabse pehle to options dekhne hain. Aneurysmal bone cyst, nahi hai, because there is no cavernous or cystic spaces, we cannot appreciate. Central giant cell granuloma, traumatic bone cyst. So, traumatic bone cyst mein kya hota hai? I'll show you the histopath. It is just a dry tap we get. So, it is not traumatic bone cyst. COC. COC mein kya dekhte hai? We see ghost cells. Can you appreciate any type of ghost cells? No. Okay. So, option here is central giant cell granuloma. Now, see the pattern here of the ghost cell. See, the ghost cell, it is randomly distributed in the stroma of the central giant cell granuloma. Now, I'll show the histopath of aneurysmal bone cyst. Okay, see, the multinucleated giant cells, it is present closer to the cystic cavity. Okay, so everybody, is it fine? Yes, multinucleated giant cells are seen in mostly all kind of pseudocysts, as we have already discussed. Okay, doctor. Now, our next question. So, we have discussed central giant cell granuloma, aneurysmal bone cyst. So, now next question. Okay, again, I have already discussed central giant cell granuloma. The giant cells evenly distributed throughout the lesion. Now, empty cavity in the mandible with no lining is most likely to be. Now, answer. It is not aneurysmal bone cyst, not dentigerous cyst, not the keratocyst. Now, remember, traumatic bone cyst. Okay, I'll explain the histopath again. Not to worry. Okay, I'll explain the histopath. Now, first see this question. Then I'll explain all the pseudocysts and their histopath. Okay? Empty cavity in the mandible with no lining is most likely to be, it is idiopathic bone cavity. It is also called as traumatic cyst. Okay, so chalo, as per, I don't know your name, it is just a dot. Okay, I'll explain the histopath of aneurysmal bone cyst. So, aneurysmal bone cyst mein kya dikhta? It is a type of pseudocyst. That means there is no epithelial lining. Epithelial lining is not there. And what do we see? Blood filled cystic spaces. So, these are blood filled cystic spaces. Now, also we have multinucleated giant cells. So, these multinucleated giant cells, these are present very much close to these cystic spaces. Okay. So, this makes the difference between the aneurysmal bone cyst and central giant cell granuloma. Okay. Coming to the traumatic cyst. traumatic cyst, all the synonyms are very, very important. As you have seen in the latest question paper, they have mentioned idiopathic bone cavity. So I have mentioned all the synonyms. So it is also called as solitary bone cyst, extravasation cyst, simple bone cyst, or the idiopathic bone cavity. So now, as we know that it is a traumatic bone cyst, that means there is some history of trauma. Now, the patient, yes, I have already mentioned other name for the idiopathic bone cavity, doctor. Okay, now there is what happens, the patient has forgotten the history of trauma. So, whenever there is a trauma, as usual, there will be bleeding. Bleeding ke baad kya hota hai? क्लॉट फॉर्मेशन होता है, देन देयर इज ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑफ क्लॉट. नाउ यहाँ पे क्या होता है, व्हाट प्रॉब्लम हियर इज दैट दिस क्लॉट इज नॉट गेटिंग ऑर्गेनाइज एंड देयर इज अ फॉर्मेशन ऑफ, ओके, एब्सोल्युटली एब्सोल्युटली ज्योति, ओके, बट हियर द क्लॉट इज नॉट ऑर्गेनाइज एंड देयर इज अ फॉर्मेशन ऑफ पैथोलॉजिकल कैविटी लीडिंग टू द नॉन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑफ क्लॉट फॉर्मेशन. तो मोस्ट कॉमनली इट इज सीन इन मैंडिबुलर पोस्टीरियर एरिया. तो स्टेफनेसिस, द डिफरेंशियल डायग्नोसिस इज स्टेफनेसिस, स्टेफनेसिस फॉर द इडियोपैथिक बोन कैविटी. नाउ कमिंग टू द हिस्टोपैथ ऑफ ट्रोमैटिक सिस्ट, कैन यू सी दिस, देयर वाज अ सिस्ट, द सर्जन हैज ओपन द सिस्ट, कैन यू सी दिस, ड्राई द कैविटी इज कंप्लीटली, देयर इज नो सिस्टिक फ्लूइड इज प्रेजेंट इन द कैविटी. ओके, we get dry tap. So when enucleation is done, clot debris, when the clot debris we aspirate, we get dry tap, no cystic fluid is present. Okay, now there are numerous bone tumors having soap bubble appearance or the honeycomb appearance. It is central giant cell granuloma, aneurysmal bone cyst, as we have already discussed in the histopath. Large, this big cystic spaces will be seen as soap bubble appearance. Ameloblastoma, ossifying fibroma, to ye sare naam likh lo, theek hai? If you have not mentioned, just write all these names at the back of your notes. Odontogenic myxoma, remember we have covered this in our life class. Sarcomas and all the arteriovenous malformations. So all these pseudocysts, even the trauma, it is occurring as a result of arteriovenous malformation. Now coming to our next question, that see all these questions which I'm covering today, these are just the past year question, and at the end of the session you will tell me ki ma'am ha ye questions to hame aate the and we have done this in the live class. Okay, to koi great question nahi aane wala exam mein. All the question absolutely I'll share the PDF macrophage. Okay, so all these questions have been done in the live class, you have done this in your past year question recall session. तो क्वेश्चन ऐसे ही आने वाले एग्जाम में, तो जस्ट व्हाट यू हैव टू डू, बी परसिस्टेंट, होप नहीं छोड़ना है, ठीक है, होप नहीं छोड़ना है, बी परसिस्टेंट एंड होप नहीं छोड़ना है, ठीक है. इंट्रा एपिथेलियल स्प्लिट इज सीन इन, नहीं, इंट्रा एपिथेलियल स्प्लिट, अच्छा चलो ठीक है, चलो अब मैं ये क्वेश्चन पूछूंगी, सुप्रा बेसिलर स्प्लिट, सुप्रा बेसिलर स्प्लिट, सुप्रा बेसिलर स्प्लिट, इट इज सीन इन, आंसर, इट इज सीन इन पेम्फिगस वल्गारिस. ओके, तो इंट्रा एपिथेलियल मतलब क्या है, विद इन द एपिथेलियम मतलब बीच में. वन सेकेंड, या ओके, सी हियर द आंसर इज सी. Now what happens, why there is intraepithelial cell destruction, because of which structure is getting destructed here, it is desmosomes, it is desmosomes, because why, these desmosomes, what they will do, they are help in attaching the cells, okay, not the hemidesmosomes. Hemidesmosomes, it will lead to subbasilar split, which is seen in cessatrigal pemphigoid or the bullous pemphigoid. While in pemphigus vulgaris we see supra basilar split. So desmosomes to intercellular junction kar raha hai na, why everybody has said B, desmosomes to intercellular junction ko attachment mein help kar raha hai, right everybody, fine. Now what happens here, desmosomes act as a foreign to bodies and antibodies are forming against these desmosomes, leading to the mutation of both desmoglein 1 and 3. So both desmoglein 1 and 3 are affected, then both the skin and the mucosa will will be affected. So when we see on the immunofluorescence, which pattern is this? This is a classical chicken wire pattern. Chicken wire pattern. Okay. So nobody, I don't want anyone to do mistake in this question, because I have taught this many many times, and INI mein to ye do baar repeat ho gaya. Same year, both the May INI and the November INI, they have asked the same question with different pattern. Okay, there was a question also on Nikolsky sign. So Nikolsky sign, it is positive in all except the bullous and cissatrical pemphigoid. We don't see Nikolsky sign. Chalo. Now, agar ye destruction, agar what will happen if there will be destruction of this intercellular junction, to kya hoga? There will be space created. To fluid kaha present hai? Because of destruction in this intercellular junction, which will lead to the accumulation of fluid. Yahan pe fluid accumulate ho jata, leading to the formation of blister. To split will be seen above the basal layer, called as suprabasilar split. Intact basal layer has been compared with the row of tombstone appearance. There is an intact basal layer, suprabasilar split. Koi confusion nahi. Acha chalo, I'll talk about the Nikolsky sign. Nikolsky sign. I don't know your name. It will be easier for me if you will just mention your name. Nikolsky sign, it is positive in pemphigus vulgaris. It is positive in pemphigus vulgaris. Staphylococcal scalded skin syndrome. Just go back to your notes or just see the recorded if you have. Okay, just see that. You will be very clear. But for now, I'm telling you, bullous pemphigoid, bullous and cissatrical negative, we see false Nikolsky sign. We don't see Nikolsky sign. ठीक है, इसके बाद I do not want to repeat the same answer की bullous or cissatrical. I don't know कि किस book में कहाँ लिखा है, dental pulse or whatever you book you are following, but bullous and cissatrical pemphigoid में we don't see Nikolsky sign. Just make this as a gold standard. Okay. चलो, our next question. Bullous membrane pemphigoid, bullous and cissatrical. Okay, mucous membrane pemphigoid was given, which to choose. Theek hai, I'll ask if in which paper was this question asked. Generally in your paper both the options won't be given. Trust me when I'm saying this, both the options won't be given. Theek hai? Now, yeah. Now, most common, so there was three question which was asked in the INI November paper about the meiosis. I know this topic, it is slightly out of from your syllabus, but this was asked in INI paper, which sometimes they tend to give the questions from here and there, because obviously that is INI. So we will follow that. This question they might ask you in your NEET paper. Okay. Okay, so most common site in the oral cavity for the meiosis to occur. So there were three questions. I will just discuss the three questions. Which of these countries has maximum prevalence for the oral meiosis? Which of these are not characteristic feature of oral meiosis? Now see, this question was asked from one of the article. Okay, I'll just read out. The most affected countries was India for the oral meiosis, followed by Brazil. Second most common, it is Brazil. And the most common site, so many many students have, they had doubt ki ma'am palate bhi likha hua hai bahut sare questions mein, bahut sare answers mein, but no, palate, it is not palate, gingiva, then the palate. Then gingiva was 29%, palate was 25%. Okay, so let's just mark this MCQ. Most common site in the oral cavity for meiosis to occur, it is gingiva. Okay, which of these countries has the highest prevalence for oral meiosis? It is India. Which of these are not characteristic feature of oral meiosis? So oral meiosis, it is generally occur as a result of larva, or these larva, these are called as maggots. Now they will come to the infected area or the oral wounds, they will come there and lead to the formation of oral meiosis. So obviously poor oral hygiene, इट विल लीड टू ओरल मियासिस, इम्यूनो कॉम्प्रोमाइज पेशेंट, और वेन एवर द वूंड इज ओपन मियासिस विल अकर देयर. ओके, सो द ओनली आंसर हियर इज प्रोक्लिनेशन ऑफ लोअर एंटीरियर्स. ओके, नॉट द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक फीचर ऑफ ओरल मियासिस. सो मियासिस एज डिस्कस्ड, इट इज एन इन्फेक्शन कॉज्ड बाय डिपोजिशन ऑफ लाइल लार्वा. दीज लार्वा, दीज आर कॉल्ड एज मैगट्स. Now, oral miasis, it is very, very, very rare. It is very, very, very rare and most commonly seen in the tropical region, higher in India, followed by Brazil. Brazil. Most common site, it is gingiva, followed by palate, and it is most commonly seen in these extracted wounds. When these wounds are very open, they get infected and these larvae, they come to this infected site. Okay, so now I know there was a slight controversy in this question, so I will discuss it here because I have been getting doubts from this question from many of you. Okay, so snow cap defect of incisors and permanent molars. So as discussed, snow cap defect, it is seen in amelogenesis imperfecta. Okay, so here the answer is very direct, amelogenesis imperfecta. Now the next question, snow cap defect of incisors and permanent molars with obliteration of pulp chamber. So, haven't I told you obliteration of pulp chamber kaun kaun se conditions mein dikhta hai? One second. So, conditions which we see increase in the size of pulp chamber. Okay. So, here there is an increase in the size of pulp chamber. But if there will be large dentine formation, so what it will lead to? It will lead to obliteration of the pulp chamber. ठीक है, नाउ यहाँ पे दोनों चीज दी हुई है, स्नो कैप डिफेक्ट भी दिया हुआ है, ऑब्लिटरेशन ऑफ द पल्प चेंबर. बट अमीलोजेनेसिस इम्परफेक्टा का, अमीलोजेनेसिस इम्परफेक्टा का एज अ देयर इज अ नो डायरेक्ट कनेक्शन विद द पल्प, ऑब्लिटरेशन ऑफ द पल्प चेंबर, बिकॉज ऑब्वियसली अमीलोजेनेसिस इम्परफेक्टा, इट विल नॉट हैम्पर द डेंटिन. द डेंटिन इज टोटली क्लियर, डेंटिन इज टोटली क्लियर. सो दैट इज वाई ऑब्लिटरेशन ऑफ पल्प चेंबर हमें किसमें दिखता है? डेंटिनोजेनेसिस इम्परफेक्टा. Dentinogenesis imperfecta. ठीक है? Now this is the type of amelogenesis imperfecta. Type 1 is hypoplastic, type 2 hypomaturation, type 3 hypocalcification, and type 4 is the combined with torodontism. With torodontism. The snow cap defect, see, it is a type 2C. It is a potential NEET MCQ question. This has never asked in your paper which type of amelogenesis imperfecta gives snow cap defect. It is type 2 maturation, that is type 2C. Pura chart yaad rakhne ki koi zarurat nahi. Okay, it is not important. Now tell me, conditions in which we see increase in the size of pulp chamber. Conditions in which we see increase in the size of pulp chamber. So we have dentinogenesis imperfecta type 2, dentine dysplasia type 2, ghost teeth, torodontism and internal resorption. Very, very, very important. Very important. Okay. Now, in this, just give me a second. I'm searching for your queries. I'm not able to get the group. Okay. Amelogenesis imperfecta and dentinogenesis imperfecta. In amelogenesis imperfecta, only the enamel is getting affected. Okay. Dentinogenesis imperfecta, the dentine will get affected. Okay. So it is not very easy to differentiate it clinically. But I have shown you all the images associated with the amelogenesis imperfecta and the dentinogenesis imperfecta in our live session. Okay. सो मोस्ट मैलिग्नेंट लीजन, मोस्ट मैलिग्नेंट लीजन, ये तो बहुत ईजी क्वेश्चन है. ठीक है, मोस्ट मैलिग्नेंट लीजन ल्यूकोप्लेकिया, विकिमस्ट्राय. विकिमस्ट्राय कौन से कंडीशन में दिखता है? इट इज सीन इन लाइकेन प्लैनस. ओके, एरिथ्रो ल्यूकोप्लेकिया. सो बेस्ट ऑप्शन हियर इज एरिथ्रो ल्यूकोप्लेकिया. नाउ इफ दे वुड हैव गिवन प्रोलिफरेटिव वेरुकस ल्यूकोप्लेकिया, देन योर फर्स्ट ऑप्शन शुड हैव बीन प्रोलिफरेटिव वेरुकस ल्यूकोप्लेकिया. ओके, so what is leukoplakia? These are basically the red and white plaques, and it has a higher potential that it can convert into the malignant transformation. So there are three types, homogeneous hota hai, granular and speckled. Okay, theek hai, to homogeneous has very less chance of getting converted into malignancy. स्पेक्टल्ड एंड नोड्यूलर हैज अ हायर रिस्क ऑफ गेटिंग कन्वर्टेड इनटू मैलिग्नेंसी. ओके दिस इज द ऑर्डर यू शुड ऑलवेज फॉलो. प्रोलिफरेटिव वेरुकस ल्यूकोप्लेकिया, देन एरिथ्रोल्यूकोप्लेकिया, ल्यूकोप्लेकिया इरोसिव लाइकेन प्लैनिस एंड लीनिया एल्बा. तो लीनिया एल्बा तो ये बस नॉर्मल व्हाइट स्ट्राइशंस, इट इज सीन नॉर्मली इन ह्यूमन इंडिविजुअल, सो दिस शुड नॉट बी देयर. नाउ all three germ layers are involved in, all three germ layers are involved in. Okay, so now we varicose, proliferative varicose leukoplakia or the varicose leukoplakia, say, okay, we will always give preference to the varicose leukoplakia. All three germ layers are involved in. So, theek hai, just remember this as a Gardner's syndrome. Theek hai, Gardner syndrome pe bahut questions aaye hain. Theek hai, there are many questions they have asked about the Gardner syndrome. ओके एब्सोल्युटली राइट. इफ दे हैव मेंशन्ड स्पेक्टल एंड प्रोलिफरेटिव, इट इज ऑलवेज प्रोलिफरेटिव वेरुकस ल्यूकोप्लेकिया. ओके नाउ द गार्डनर सिंड्रोम, छह पॉइंट्स बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. सबसे पहले तो गैस्ट्रो इंटेस्टिनल पॉलिप्स होता है. ठीक है, गार्डनर सिंड्रोम में वी सी गैस्ट्रो इंटेस्टिनल पॉलिप्स. नाउ दीज गैस्ट्रो इंटेस्टिनल पॉलिप्स, दे हैव 100%, इट इज सेड दैट इट हैज 100% दैट इट विल कन्वर्ट इन टू मैलिग्नेंसी. सो इफ दे हैव मेंशनड अदर ऑप्शन एंड विच एंड दे हैव आस्क्ड हाइएस्ट पोटेंशियल फॉर द मैलिग्नेंट ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन, इट इज Gardner syndrome. Okay, it is Gardner syndrome. Now what do we see in Gardner syndrome? Adenocarcinoma, transformation into adenocarcinoma, multiple osteomas, odontomas, supernumerary teeth, so multiple impacted supernumerary teeth, epidermoid cyst and the desmoid tumor. Very important with respect to Gardner syndrome. Bas ye yaad rakh lo sare important points, you will remember the Gardner syndrome. Theek hai, now again there was a question but with different form, but we're different from which is not associated with cleft lip and palate. तो अभी तो हमने देखा Gardner syndrome में बस यही हो सकते हैं, 7-8 point हो सकते हैं. ठीक है, so now they have mentioned Gardner syndrome, very easy, cake walk question, just mark this Gardner syndrome. Now that is why life class is very important. Life class is very important. If you have seen the life class or the recorded, absolutely perfect. Okay, tell me, Peare-Robbins syndrome, do we see? We obviously see cleft lip, cleft palate. Van der Woods syndrome, we see cleft lip and cleft palate, and even we see in the popliteal pterygium syndrome. Now yes, we see supernumerary teeth, we see multiple, just remember this term, multiple impacted supernumerary teeth. So there will be lot of impacted tooth, so obviously if there are teeth which is present extra in number, that will be called as supernumerary teeth. Now a 40-year-old patient comes with a swelling in the posterior mandible. ठीक है, तो उन्होंने बता दिया कि ये तो amyloblastoma है. ठीक है, they have mentioned that this is a amyloblastoma. Now you tell me what is the type of amyloblastoma. Plexiform follicular acanthomatous clear cell amyloblastoma. So we know that there are 6 histopathological features of amyloblastoma. ठीक है, so what are the 6 histopathological? So the basic form of the amyloblastoma is Peare-Robbins syndrome mein cleft lips dikhta hai bhai, it is seen in Peare-Robbins syndrome. ठीक है, तो amyloblastoma 6 histopathological variant of amyloblastoma. So as in general rule, follicular amyloblastoma, चलो आई डिस्कस दिस क्वेश्चन, देन यू टेल मी द आंसर. ओके, सो एज अ जनरल रूल फॉलिकुलर अमीलोब्लास्टोमा में क्या होता है, पेरिफेरल टॉल कॉलमनर सेल्स विद सेंटर स्टीलेट रेटिकुलम लाइक सेल्स. ठीक है, देखो अगर स्टीलेट, सो वी हैव अ पेरिफेरल टॉल कॉलमनर सेल्स एंड इन सेंटर वी हैव स्टीलेट रेटिकुलम लाइक सेल्स. This is a basic structure of follicular amyloblastoma. Now, if the metaplasia will occur in this stellate reticulum-like cells, it will give different forms of amyloblastoma like acanthomatous amyloblastoma, basal cell amyloblastoma and granular amyloblastoma. ठीक है? So basically, this is acanthomatous amyloblastoma. तो acanthomatous amyloblastoma में क्या दिखता है? We see squamous. So what the squamous cells will do? It will cause keratin production. Now, this keratin production will also be there in the squamous odontogenic tumor. Just for your revision, squamous odontogenic tumor, okay? Basal cell ameloblastoma, granular ameloblastoma. See, this is the acanthomatous ameloblastoma. What do we see here? We see keratin pulse with peripheral tall columnar cells. And in center ciliate reticulum like cells, what will happen? There will be squamous cells will be present. Can you appreciate? The squamous cells in this ciliate reticulum like cells leading to the formation of keratin pulse. Now, ameloblastoma, Robinson's has defined it as a true neoplasm. It is of enamel organ type of tissue. Okay, so it is of true epithelial in origin. Okay, first category of classification of tumor. So just remember UNIAC, that is a unicentric growth, non-functional, intermittent, that is growth is not continuous, it is anatomically benign and clinically persistent. Identify the pathology. Identify the pathology in the picture. The histopath shows excessive development of lymphatic vessels and the lymph cells. Now, what is this? Many dot-like structure, which is giving as a frog egg appearance. Frog egg appearance, which is also called as topoika pudding appearance. So up to now, this is very easy. Frog egg appearance or the topoika pudding appearance, it is seen in lymphangioma. Yes. So it is a lymphangioma. It is a benign proliferation of lymphatic vessels, most frequently seen on the anterior 2/3 of the tongue. Now, when it is seen in neck, it is called as cystic hygroma. And the surface, it will give frog egg or topoika pudding appearance. चलो ये तो बहुत इजी है ठीक है अगर क्वेश्चन ना भी देखें विद दिस इमेज वी कैन सी वी कैन मार्क द ऑप्शन ओके नाउ पेशेंट हैज शोन इन द पिक विद द स्पार्स हेयर ओवर द स्कैल्प एंड द एंटायर स्किन आई लैशेज आर एब्सेंट ऑल्सो हैज अ हाइपोहाइड्रोसिस व्हाट विल बी द क्लिनिकल डायग्नोसिस व्हाट विल बी द क्लिनिकल डायग्नोसिस सो देयर आर फाइव फीचर्स एसोसिएटेड विद द एक्टोडर्मल डिस्प्लेशिया ठीक है Ectodermal dysplasia, oligodontia, it is just a decrease in number of the teeth. Cleidocranial dysplasia and Peyer-Robert syndrome, we will discuss abhi, theek hai? So, oligodontia described as decrease in number of the tooth. Cleidocranial dysplasia, so cleidocranial dysplasia mein kya dekhte hai? Absent or reduced clavicle, failure of tooth eruption, multiple unerupted teeth will be present or the supernumerary teeth are the characteristic feature. So, Peyer-Robert syndrome, tell me the three triad which is present in Peyer-Robert syndrome. Mandibular micrognathia, that is short mandible, glossoptosis of the tongue and cleft lip or the cleft palate seen in the Peyer-Robert syndrome. Now, ectodermal dysplasia, skin will be affected. ठीक है स्किन विल बी अफेक्टेड हेयर देयर विल बी हाइपोट्राइकोसिस नेल्स विल बी अफेक्टेड व्हिच इज कॉल्ड एज ऑर्निकोडिस्प्लेशिया स्वेट ग्लैंड दैट इज हाइपोहाइड्रोसिस सो दीज फाइव थिंग्स आर इंपॉर्टेंट हाइपोहाइड्रोसिस एंड टीथ विल बी अफेक्टेड ओके नाउ देयर आर टू सिंड्रोम्स एसोसिएटेड विद एक्टोडर्मल डिस्प्लेशिया ठीक है क्राइसीमेन स्टोराइन सिंड्रोम एंड हाइड्रोटिक टाइप ऑफ एक्टोडर्मल डिस्प्लेशिया नाउ दिस इज द लेस सीवियर फॉर्म बिकॉज हियर नो डेंटल डिफेक्ट्स आर सीन व्हाइल इन Christ cement Torrine syndrome, all the defects, all the features of the ectodermal dysplasia, which we have discussed, it will be seen here. Okay. Now, a supernumerary teeth is defined as any tooth or the odontogenic structure that is formed from tooth germ in the excess of usual number for any region of the dental arch. At what stage tooth formation is formed? Now, this is a DADH question, but this query was asked by many of the students, so I thought I should take care of it. Now, अगर कोई भी टीथ फॉर्मेशन हो रहा है, ज्यादा टूथ फॉर्म हो रहा है या कम टूथ फॉर्म हो रहा है, ठीक है, दैट विल ऑब्वियसली इन विच स्टेज ऑफ टूथ डेवलपमेंट स्टेज, इट विल बी ऑलवेज एट द इनिशिएशन स्टेज, इट विल बी ऑलवेज एट द इनिशिएशन स्टेज. सो जस्ट फॉर योर रिविजन, डेवलपमेंट ऑफ टूथ इट इज डिवाइडेड इन टू थ्री स्टेजेस मेनली, दैट इज बड स्टेज, कैप स्टेज, अर्ली बेल स्टेज एंड एडवांस बेल स्टेज. नाउ दीज आर द मॉर्फोलॉजिकल स्टेजेस विच विल कोइंसाइड विद द फिजियोलॉजिकल स्टेजेस. ठीक है, नाउ डेंटल लमाइना, दैट इज डेंटल लमाइना क्या करता है, टूथ बड का फॉर्मेशन, राइट. सो इट विल हैव अ इनिशिएशन स्टेज. नाउ ऑल अदर स्टेजेस विल बी कोइंसाइडिंग विद ईच अदर. सो वी हैव प्रोलिफरेशन, हिस्टो डिफरेंशिएशन, मॉर्फो डिफरेंशिएशन एंड द अपोजिशन स्टेज. नाउ डिफरेंट स्टेजेस विल लीड टू डिफरेंट डेवलपमेंटल एनोमली. ओके, डिफरेंट डेवलपमेंटल एनोमली. नाउ ऑल दोस इन द डेवलपमेंट एनोमली, if proliferation is given, then again you will have to mark initiation, because proliferation, it will always come after initiation stage. Initiation will always lead to the development of the tooth bud. Now this development of tooth bud, it will ultimately lead to the formation of tooth. So we have to always mark initiation stage. Now the gemination, fusion, all those developmental anomaly, it will come into the morpho differentiation. Okay. So lack of initiation, yes, lack of initiation, that is single teeth or the multiple teeth, it is called as partial anodontia. So if one tooth is missing, the most commonly involved tooth is the upper lateral incisor. Remember, it is upper lateral incisor, third molars and the lower premolar. Complete lack of tooth, that is complete anodontia. Okay. Now there is a difference between the hypodontia and oligodontia. Now remember this difference, because this is very easy question and sometimes we tend to get confused. Or aise hi confusion questions aa jaate exam mein. Theek hai, hypodontia involves the absence of 1 to 5 teeth, while oligodontia involves the absence of 6 or more teeth. Okay. Now, a child complains of pain in the right leg for the last 3 months. On examination, all this diaphyseal mass, soft tissue. Okay, sometimes you will get long big question, but you have to find that exact keyword. Okay. Now, histologically showed the round blue cells with the karyotype T11, translocation 1122. What is the diagnosis? It is Ewing's sarcoma, because round blue cells, it is seen in Ewing sarcoma. Okay. Most common missing tooth, third molar. Most common missing tooth, third molar. Now, round cell malignancy with a karyotype of 11:12, it is Ewing sarcoma. Now, the question which was asked in the INI paper, that which gene mutation had led to the Ewing sarcoma. So it is Ewing sarcoma. This option was there, EWS-R1 gene or FL1 gene. So this can also be asked in your paper. So remember both the genes associated with Ewing sarcoma. Now I know many students have doubt in the primary bone malignant tumor, secondary bone malignant tumor, or the most common bone malignancy. Okay, abhi hum isko clear kar lete hain. Now, Ewing sarcoma, it is the second most common primary bone malignant tumor in pediatric patients after osteosarcoma. So, osteosarcoma, it is the most common. It is the subliquo. Osteosarcoma, it is the most common malignant tumor. It is the most common primary malignant bone tumor. ऑस्टियोसारकोमा बोथ इन चिल्ड्रंस एज वेल एज दी अडल्ट. ओके, बट इन पीडियाट्रिक पेशेंट एविंग सार्कोमा इज द सेकेंड मोस्ट कॉमन, नॉट द फर्स्ट कॉमन. एंड विच इज द मोस्ट कॉमन बोन मैलिग्नेंसी? इट इज मल्टीपल माइलोमा. इट इज मल्टीपल माइलोमा. इज एवरीबडी क्लियर ऑन दिस? सो मोस्ट कॉमन बोन मैलिग्नेंसी इट इज मल्टीपल माइलोमा. ऑस्टियोसार्कोमा इट इज द मोस्ट कॉमन प्राइमरी बोन मैलिग्नेंट ट्यूमर फॉलोड बाय एविंग सार्कोमा. Now we have very easy questions. Let's do it फटाफट. A patient come with a vascular growth in the posterior part of the palate. He is a known HIV positive case for 10 years and on antiviral therapy the lesion is diagnosed as the Kaposi sarcoma. So Kaposi sarcoma, it is HHV-8, human herpes virus 8. Okay, now human herpes virus 8, it causes adult, ma'am. See, both adult and children, most common primary bone malignant tumor, it is osteosarcoma. Most common primary bone malignant tumor, it is osteosarcoma, both in adults as well as children. Most common malignant tumor, it is multiple myeloma. Second most common in children, it is Ewing sarcoma. Okay? So, HHV-8 causes Kaposi sarcoma. Primary effusion lymphoma and Castleman disease. Castleman disease, ये बहुत बार पूछा गया है, ठीक है? You would have seen also this in microbiology. Okay, that is why I'm repeating it again because many times it has been asked. Now, but remember, most common malignancy seen in HIV. What is the most common malignancy seen in HIV? It is non-Hodgkin's lymphoma followed by Kaposi. Kaposi, it is a vascular malignancy. So if they have asked most common vascular malignancy seen in HIV patient, then it is Kaposi sarcoma. But most common malignancy seen in HIV, it is non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. Exactly. Now which of these is a low grade malignancy? So pehle to option dekhna hai, theek hai? पहले ऑप्शन देखना है. ऑल दीज आर दी सलाइवरी ग्लैंड कार्सिनोमा. ठीक है, लो ग्रेड मैलिग्नेंसी. दिस वाज आईएनआई पेपर, आज इन दी आईएनआई पेपर. ठीक है, प्लियोमॉर्फिक एडिनोमा नहीं होगा ऑप्शन में. ठीक है, बिकॉज ऑब्वियसली इट इज नॉट अ मैलिग्नेंट. अगर कार्सिनोमा एक्स प्लियोमॉर्फिक एडिनोमा बोलते देन इट वी कुड हैव कंसिडर्ड. ओके, बट प्लियोमॉर्फिक एडिनोमा इट इज नॉट मैलिग्नेंट. सो वी आर लेफ्ट विथ म्यूको एपिडर्मोइड कार्सिनोमा, एडिनोइड सिस्टिक कार्सिनोमा एंड एसेनिक सेल कार्सिनोमा. So which is the most common malignant salivary gland tumor? It is mucoepidermoid. Chalo, I'll change this question. Which is third most common salivary gland malignancy? So first most common hume pata hai mucoepidermoid. Second most common is adenoid cystic carcinoma. Third most common is SNX cell carcinoma. Okay. Now, SNX cell carcinoma, it is the third most common salivary gland neoplasm after mucoepidermoid and adenoid cystic carcinoma. Most commonly, it is composed of serous cells with abundant granular cytoplasm. See, can you see? Lot of granules are present in the... Lot of granules are present in this with lot of serous cells. These are not mucous cells. These are the serous cells. Now, most commonly seen again in the parotid gland. Generally, the carcinoma, it is most commonly seen in the intraorally, that is lips and the buccal mucosa. Now, according to the Shushi-Hashi classification of lip print, type 2 pattern it is seen in. Answer. Type 2 pattern it is seen in. It is seen in branched. Okay, it is seen in branched. So we will discuss this Shushi-Hashi classification. Okay, it is basically, it comes under the forensic odontology category. Now type 1, it is a complete straight grooves. Can you see this? It is a complete straight grooves. Type 1 dash, the grooves here are पार्शियल, देयर आर पार्शियल ग्रूव्स आर प्रेजेंट. टाइप टू, दीज आर ब्रांच, देयर इज ब्रांचिंग सीन इन द ग्रूव्स. टाइप थ्री, टाइप थ्री इज इंटरसेक्टेड, टाइप थ्री इज इंटरसेक्टेड. टाइप फोर इज द रेटिकुलर ग्रूव्स, ओके, दीज आर द रेटिकुलर ग्रूव्स. वाइल टाइप फाइव इट इज undifferentiated, that is groups which cannot be morphologically differentiated. Okay, it is basically an irregular or it can be said as undifferentiated type. Now, herringbone pattern is seen in which of the following? Very direct question. Tell me, everybody answer herringbone pattern. So this is a herringbone pattern. This is a herringbone pattern which is seen in fibrosarcoma. Okay, we will discuss others also. Fibrosarcoma is a malignant tumor of fibrosarcoma, matlab there is an involvement of fibroblast. Fibrous histiocytoma, it shows stereoform pattern, stereoform like a wheel like a pattern, staghorn pattern, theek hai, staghorn aisa humne class mein dekha tha, theek hai, it is seen in hemangiopericytoma. Remember this, it is very important. Now diagnose the given image, theek hai. Can you see multiple white and yellowish kind of spot most commonly seen in buccal mucosa? So it is Fordyce granules. Okay. Now, these are just the ectopic sebaceous gland. Now, majority of the time it is seen in normal individuals. Okay. It is absolutely normal to have Fordyce granules. Okay. Now, what are these? They appear yellowish spot seen in the 80% of the population with a normal anatomic variation. Now what it is most important, it is seen in buccal mucosa and the lateral portion of the vermilion of the upper lip. Okay, now what are these? These are ectopic sebaceous gland. See, this is ectopic sebaceous gland. So this is a Fordyce granule. Okay, so image, histopath image can be asked in your paper and they will ask what this condition is, what is the differential diagnosis for this condition. Now everyone, oral hairy leukoplakia, it is caused by Epstein-Barr virus. Okay, so it is oral hairy leukoplakia caused by Epstein-Barr virus, most commonly seen in the agar lateral border of tongue hai and the patient is also HIV positive, then first diagnosis it should be go with oral hairy leukoplakia. Now it was first reported by Greenspan, theek hai, Greenspan, that is why it is also called as Greenspan lesion. Acha, remember cytomegalovirus, it is HHV5, while HHV8 it causes Kaposi sarcoma. Okay, Greenspan syndrome, this is wrong, Greenspan bada term hai, okay, Greenspan bada term hai, okay, that is why oral hairy leukoplakia, okay, it is a bigger form. Now Greenspan syndrome, it consists of triad of lichen planus, diabetes mellitus and hypertension. Okay, Greenspan, okay, Greenspan, just remember it is a bigger term, so it is associated with oral hairy leukoplakia, most commonly seen in HIV patient and it is caused by Epstein-Barr virus. Greenspan syndrome, it is seen in oral lichen planus or the lichen planus. So what is this syndrome? It consists of lichen planus, diabetes mellitus and hypertension. So remember, in the Greenspan syndrome, we should never prescribe corticosteroids. Why? Because corticosteroids are never prescribed in diabetes mellitus and the hypertension patient. Okay, never prescribed. So your question can be asked as, in which condition we should not prescribe corticosteroids if Greenspan syndrome is there? Because obviously it has diabetes mellitus and hypertension, so we will not prescribe. Okay, now there is a one question, it is there in your MCQ textbook, it is just a rectified question. Just remember, Kuttner's tumor, it most commonly involves the सब मैंडुलर ग्लैंड, ज्यादा दिमाग ही नहीं लगाना है. तो व्हाट इज दिस कटनर्स ट्यूमर? इट इज बेसिकली द क्रॉनिक स्क्लीरोजिंग साइलीडिनाइटिस ऑफ द सब मैंडुलर ग्लैंड. तो व्हाट इज साइलीडिनाइटिस? इट इज जस्ट द इन्फ्लेमेशन ऑफ द सलाइवरी ग्लैंड. एंड द मोस्ट कॉमन वायरल इन्फेक्शन अफेक्टिंग द सलाइवरी ग्लैंड, इट इज द पेरोटिड ग्लैंड कॉज्ड बाय मम्स, कॉज्ड बाय मम्स. ठीक है, सो दिस वॉज द रिकॉल ऑफ द पास्ट ईयर क्वेश्चन मैराथन. नाउ गाइज, फॉर द हिस्टोपैथोलॉजिकल इमेज, ओके, यू जस्ट हैव टू सी दैट वॉट दे आर पॉइंटिंग टू शो, ओके, वॉट दे वॉन्ट टू शो. सो यू जस्ट हैव टू रिमेंबर दैट पर्टिकुलर पॉइंट विथ रेस्पेक्ट टू, जस्ट आई हैव टोल्ड यू एन्यूरिज्मल बोन्सेस. अब हमें क्या एपिथीलियम है वो सब कुछ नहीं देखना, जस्ट सी दैट देर इज अ बिग कैविटी विच इज प्रेजेंट एंड द मल्टी न्यूक्लिएटेड जॉइंट सेल. ठीक है, क्वेश्चन जो भी आएगा दैट विल कम फ्रॉम द सिलेबस. यू जस्ट हैव टू सी द हिस्टोपैथ इमेज अगेन एंड अगेन. तो ये जो भी पीडीएफ है, वॉट एवर द क्वेश्चन, इमेजेस बेस्ड क्वेश्चन विच यू हैव, सेव इट इन योर फोन एंड सी इट कंटिन्यूअसली. तो यू विल बी एबल टू लोकेट एग्जैक्टली वॉट दे वॉन्ट टू आस्क एन एग्जाम इन योर पेपर. ठीक है, लाइक एन्यूरिज्मल बोन सिस्ट आई हैव मेंशनड, लाइक अगेन सेंट्रल जॉइंट सेल ग्रैनुलोमा, कोई कैवर्नस स्पेसेस नहीं दिख रहा, हमें जस्ट मल्टी न्यूक्लिएटेड जॉइंट सेल दिख रहा है. ठीक है, सो इन दिस वे इट विल बी इजियर फॉर यू टू रिमेंबर. एंड ट्रस्ट मी, दिस 2 months, ये 2 महीने तुमसे कोई नहीं छीन सकता. डोंट क्रिब अबाउट इट, 2 महीने दीज आर सफिशियंट फॉर योर पेपर, दीज आर सफिशियंट फॉर योर पेपर. सो आई विश यू ऑल बेस्टेस्ट ऑफ लक. एंड इफ यू गाइज हैव एनी डाउट, एज यूजल आई से इन ऑल माई सेशन, if you have any doubt contact me anytime, contact me anytime. I will give you my number 8095165551. If you have any doubt related to anything, academic, non-academic, just give me a call, or you can email me, or you can telegram me. I am everywhere. Okay, so I wish you all bestest of luck. So bye everyone.